So like you have to go miss stage a lot of times, and Jigs can punish that by saying if you go miss stage, I go for rest. Sing rest. And if you go to ledge with like a tech roll, I go for a forward air, chase those stages with forward airs, and you're done anyway.
Yeah.
And then neutral, her air movement's so crazy. And versus Pikachu, that's how much disjoints.
Mm.
It's actually trading for Jigglypuff is bad, but Pikachu's so many multi hits, so he doesn't really want to force trades either. Oh, right. Just going right into it.
Okay. Yeah, no button check needed, man. These guys are ready to go into it. So entice camel.
Yep.
Coming through against HBox. I mean, it's gonna be interesting to see how this one plays out. As I said, hey, I just like seeing the melee players like doing well in this game, because I know this is like a huge difference than what they're like used to, but they're still making it work.
Ooh, I want to mention that side B is actually pretty safe in block for this game. Like, if you try to do like a slow punish, you won't get it on Pikachu side B now.
Right.
Yep.
Pikachu?
Yeah, Pikachu's.
Yeah, yeah, it bounces off the shield now, so it looks a lot better. Okay.
Oh, we see the chase right there, and now he's backing off. He knows he can't chase too far.
Yeah, he already used a couple jumps.
That's it.
No!
That's it.
Air dodge jump? Yeah.
Oh.
Bro, it has distance. It has distance. That's his up B. Like, I mean, he definitely can't up B any other way with a thing, so he just has to air dodge up and hope for the best.
One thing I'm noticing is HBox is definitely challenging T-Jolts by, like, hitting them or trying to, like, jumping over with hitbox every time.
Right.
Or through, as you see right there.
Yeah, that Nair is doing wonders for him right now in this matchup as far as getting through the Thunder Drone and catching Pikachu, who's probably most likely trying to approach after the Thunder Drone anyway with keeping that pressure up.
Yep. You know, so using that platform there really effectively to go around the T-Jolts. I want to see Pikachu do that exactly. T-Jolt the platform itself, stop the jumping. Jigs is not really that scary when she's approaching from the ground.
Yeah, you can definitely tell that that Camel was, like, down to, like, you know, play this long game with HBox. Like, he's definitely sitting on the other side. You know, he knows that HBox is probably going to have to approach. Even though HBox is winning, or as far as the percent goes, it's just, you know, he's the slower character. And so Pikachu can kind of play around him, not in the air as much, but, you know, he definitely play around him on the ground, so.
Yep, getting those small hits when he can. Of course, Jigglypuff is very hard to combo, and Jigglypuff is effectively heavier than you would expect versus combo-based characters.
Right.
Because they lose a lot of their combos.
Right. All right, not being the lightest character in the game anymore either, so that's got to be nice.
Pichu's actually that by a huge margin. I think it's like 8 or so points.
Yeah, it's 8 points, man. It went from 4 to 12, and I was like, Jesus, like, what kind of jump is this? All right.
Same. Yep, you see, right now it looks like Campbell just built up a nice little, like, taking back some percent. No, he's not getting killed.
Ooh, okay, good air dodge out.
I feel like HBox is kind of respecting Campbell too much. Never mind. There was no respect there.
Yeah, that forward air, I'm hopping in here. I'm jamming this in, so. Either way. 84% on to HBox. I mean, he's not really crazy in kill percentage for most of Pikachu's options. Pikachu probably get a nice F smash, possibly even an up smash, but both of those options are a little risky. The dash attack almost working.
Yep. Pikachu's dash attack is actually insane now. Kills, not too much end leg, and since Pikachu's so small, it's hard to hit that with aerials.
I've noticed that, like, HBox, when I was playing him yesterday, too, like, his parry game is decently on point, man. He got a couple parry rests on me and everything.
That's crazy. That's a scary game.
That's a huge punish, yeah. So ends up getting the up smash here. I feel like we're gonna be in for a longer game. I think that's kind of what Jigglypuff kind of forced you to do. You don't wanna like keep jumping into jigs and then end up getting blown up by your own, you know, impatience. So.
Yep, and definitely I noticed Campbell is he's doing his best when he's just kind of playing the slow game versus HBox. Whereas when he's approaching, you know, HBox is just stuffing those out, punishing that shield, and I think Campbell has to wait for the proper approach using T-Jolts.
Right.
Or let HBox approach him.
Whoa.
That's all a free... Right. Oh, no. Doesn't convert off that.
Yeah, it was like kind of a free punish, but it wasn't able to get in there after he hit that jolt.
Yeah.
So still got the damage from the jolt, but I mean, he could have got way more than that.
Yeah, HBox is kind of just fishing for the hard read. He wanted to go for that. I'm a top player. You're going to roll in. I'm going to punish you, Reed.
All right. Back off the ledge. Yep. 107 here already on this Pikachu, man. So definitely back in danger. Here. Oh, that was clean.
There, that was nice.
That looked like an actual bait with that back air. Like, great space back air one, but also end up... He ended up missing his F tilt, so he ended up getting F smash forward. Good stuff.
Even HBox like leaned back in his chair where that happened. Like, I did that.
Yep.
Okay, we got back here, catch the jump. You know, one thing that's so hard is that Pikachu can't challenge Jigglypuff's jumps properly. CC has to like find openings between the hitboxes as opposed to during them.
All right, taking that.
That's.
All right, what a way to even it up, man.
Yeah,
HBox hanging out
region.
A little too far up there. And then he was like, well, take this thunder, bro.
Yeah, he was not even anticipating an option like that.
Not at all.
But forward air, you know, he still has the lead. Campbell's still fighting from a decently big deficit.
Yeah.
69%. dash tech catch away.
Oh!
Oh my, HBox. You don't need to style a man like this, you know?
He's still looking, okay, he's still looking for it, he's still looking for it.
You know, if HBox loses this game, he deserves trying to style too much.
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised he's doing it like just in neutral like that. I don't even think that Campbell's been giving him that many roles for him to expect that. Like, if he could get him on the platforms and stuff, then maybe he'll be able to get a sync through the platform.
No.
But as of current, yeah, no, I don't think that that Camo's been rolling in as much as HBox is playing like he is.
Yeah, Camo's been jumping in a lot mainly, or T-jolting. So
yeah.
The one thing is, Campbell's using my T-jolts, he's not going to get hard punishes on those sings if he already has a T-jolt coming out as HBox sings.
That's true. So I guess it's like, it's kind of risk versus reward for HBox, because he knows he's not going to take a hard punish because my man has always been throwing out these T-jolts. So.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yep. Nair from above. Oh. Beat the up air.
About to be the game right there. Yep, long lasting hitbox from that forward
air.
That's
not it. Nope. Nah, mid stage. And I saw Campbell was already DI'ing. Like, he was T-jolting, he was holding forward.
Yeah.
Next backer, though, doesn't matter where you're at, unless you're across the stage. I always get afraid, though, when HBox puts himself in the corner. Because then, like, one meaty forward, not meaty, one strong forward smash will end that stock with bad DI.
Right, man.
I feel like he's fishing for something right now like that.
HBox or
Campbell. He's looking to do some of that kill move. I think up throw thunder would work with bad DI from HBox as well.
Yeah, but HBox is, I mean, I feel like he's been playing around the grab quite well as far as this set has been going.
Oh, he's used to Fox and Melee. Yeah, forget about it. He's not getting grabbed.
Oh,
that's
okay,
a suck.
That could have been it right there. That's double dash attack, nothing on the shield. That could have been an up smash immediately out of shield. Done game.
I feel like he's looking for parries on the on dash attack to do rest. But yeah, he needs to get a kill. He doesn't want to make this game last too long.
Yeah.
You know, he's just running around the platforms. Can't believe he's a challenge HBox when he's jumping around the platforms, honestly. He can't let HBox just run around for free.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe. I think HBox probably trying to turn around and get a back throw or something right there, but he ends up getting jabbed up, man. 76%. Gotta watch yourself, man. That's one up smash away.
One thing I noticed about Jinx is she doesn't have a good outshot option. Her aerial is like, her nair doesn't have a big range. Forward air won't hit Jinx, Pikachu, in my opinion, because rising forward is gonna be a little bit too high up, same with back air. So it looks like HBox can block Pikachu attack, doesn't have the proper punish. Oh, nice back air though. Challenging the forward air. That back air still is a nice range.
Nice range and nice knockback too, man. He almost killed cross stage a little earlier on, but unfortunately for him, yeah, that cross stage definitely kept Pikachu alive to see another day. Very close game. You know, Camel, or I feel like HBox was definitely in the lead for most of it, but Camel almost brought that back. I mean, he pretty much brought it back to just, one solid smash would have been able to take it, or possibly, as you said, up throw thunder if it was quick and it caught HBox's DI off guard, so.
Yeah. No, that was definitely a good comeback from Campbell. I think HBox still has it, though. I think he's going to stop messing around as much, honestly, because he could close out a lot earlier. He just started being a little bit too respectful of his opponent, honestly. You know, he's just stopped throwing hitboxes out, period.
Yeah. Yeah, so here we are into game two out here in Smashville.
No, this is going to stage for Pikachu because he can set Pikachu on the mid platform.
Right.
And they'll spin around the platform.
So he's got that going for him. That's great. Also, probably, I mean, you know, even though we're playing with a shorter character, that just forced an option that HBox is not allowed to do now, though. He can't jump, otherwise he's going to get hit by that.
Also, Pikachu can definitely do, like, up air strings, land on a platform, continue the strings for a little bit of extra free credit on the combos. Nothing crazy. Like, as you see here right now. Oh, no, we didn't do it.
Yeah, doesn't actually land right there. I thought he was going to try to land, get another up air.
Jinx is still too hard to combo for that.
Yeah, you see how far he flew? Like, Jesus, that man was gone.
Yep. Okay. Oh, down air? Oh, I just got the spike, though. I could have been a stock.
I like HBox's option there, though, to go for that for that puff. I mean, one, it's the long-lasting hitbox. As soon as it's done, I mean, he just grabs the ledge, so it's like a forced trump at that point in time.
Yep. Uh-oh, dash attack the landing. You know, HBox is kind of getting blown up a little bit right now. You know, he's trying to find openings to get in, but Campbell is just not letting this happen.
Ooh.
Oh, there it is. That's the forward smash. Finally does it.
I think Campbell's starting to catch on to that, as you noted in the first game, that HBox has definitely been trying to kick through a lot of these jolts. So he tried to kick through that with the nair and just caught the F smash on the other side. Uh-oh.
You can't kick through that jolt. That's footstool.
Wait. I think he might have had another jump, but yeah, I think he could have.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he's going to let it go.
You know what he's trying to do? He's trying to intimidate Campbell by saying, nah, I can't do this, and saying, actually, I'm lying. I can do this, man. Okay, now he's done. Game three right now.
Game three. I mean, this is a lot to come back for unless HBox gets, you know, his melee level comebacks right now with a bunch of rest. Like, yeah, this is he's still barely even had. Oh, there it is.
Oh, there it. That's one stock.
Yep, that's one.
Only needs two more, but it's still.
I feel like he only needs to get him like 50 too before he actually attempts that. So,
Oh my god, Campbell's taking a breather. He knows he shouldn't freak out, he still has a lead. That's the biggest thing. When something like that happens to you, remember, your opponent is doing this stuff because he feels nervous. Don't let that nervousness get to you as well.
I hear someone yelling about how HBox is going to do it to him, and I wonder if he's talking about that reverse down air to rest. So.
Oh, that's a bad roll.
Hold up, this HBox momentum.
Okay, now, game three.
Got to get a harder punish to that, man. I mean, Sing only works if you're on the ground. So, like, if you jump into him, you know, like, just jump into him in a neutral air or something and see if you can get something off that that drag down or whatever. But he just went for a jolt instead. I don't even think he actually hit the jolt.
I think Campbell's getting a little bit too nervous, though. Like, he's throwing at these moves he doesn't need to. If he has such a good stock lead, you know, he just need to fish for kills. He can just hold that lead with more safe options, get the kills when he sees them, instead of fishing for these forward smashes.
Yeah.
Yeah, play the game you were playing before, Campbell.
Okay.
Read the jump with the forward air, that kind of stuff.
There's an HBox is trying to get back on the stage. Campbell honestly giving up all the stage control, but like he already knew that HBox meant to land eventually. He got that free dash attack.
Jiggs looks so mad when she's throwing someone, pummeling someone.
Hold up, man. Is this really the comeback? I mean, this is a respectable reverse three stock if he gets this. I mean, he gave that second stock up in a way that I think he might have been able to actually try to pound and grab the ledge, but he didn't go for it. Just died. Oh.
If he got the hit, I feel like he was going to go for like a tech read. Rest.
27% already to this 96. I mean, this is definitely one smash away, but and now he's using his platform as great landing spots. I mean, like, Pikachu not really going to be able to cure you in the air that well, and not as well as he can do it on the ground.
Oh my god, that was so close. And HBox, you know, I feel like he knows Cam wants to throw a hitbox sign. He's waiting for Cam to throw out a smash. He wants to punish those smashes.
Yeah.
Campbell just has to play really patiently. I wouldn't fish for those offstage fares like that. Instead, cover the ledge with thunders and fares. You know, let HBox come to him.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Almost got the dash attack.
Still. I just want to note that this match is going a lot quicker than the last one.
It is.
Largely because Campbell is trying to, like, throw him. Uh-oh.
Oh, my.
Down air thunder.
Oh, that was close. That air dodge takes forever because you still have to fall 100 units, and Jiggs got that super slow fall speed. But luckily for him, luckily for Jiggs, he also has a lot of aerial drifts, so he can mix up where he's trying to land.
Yeah, we should actually talk about that for a second. When you air dodge in this game, every character falls the same height after every air dodge.
Right.
It's just a matter of how fast you get to that height with the air dodge.
I think it's 100 units you have to fall. So yeah, if you have a super low fall speed, obviously it takes you forever to get out, and that's why characters like Wolf seems as though their air dodge, you know, it's seeming just a lot better, their directional one, because they fall so quick that it's like they're out and they can act immediately.
For example, I think it's like Rose has about 70 frames, so like Jiggs have the same about time for regular air dodge, which is Wolf is like 30-ish frames before he can act out air dodge. That's a stock.
Okay, man.
Calling out that.
Yeah, you had to give him that one, but still, what a comeback from HBox, bringing it all the way to 93% after he started that. He started that three-stock game at 70% on Camel's first stock.
Yep. No, Campbell needs to just chill out a little bit because HBox is definitely getting into his head really hard. Actually, I think Campbell is just letting HBox get into his head.
Yeah, sometimes just a name, dude. Just a name will kind of get to you.
Oh, yeah, no, top player privilege is real. It's actually amazing. I definitely have those games where I'm going to lose. My opponent just SDs a 20, and I'm just like, yeah, good games, man. I definitely outplayed you. It wasn't just me being me that won me the game, you know?
It's like, I got to play against the buds. Yeah, man, that joint happens all the time, y'all, man. So I definitely get it, but I know that HBox is like, he is a respectable player in his own right, in his own game, and he's a respectable player in this game too, but that does not mean he cannot fall at the early, the early functions of Ultimate.
No, the top player scare tactic is starting a set and like almost not saying anything, like, okay, sup, dude? You want to go PS2? Cool, good luck, have fun, and that's it. No, like, banter, you know, win a game with just saying ban this with, like, any banter and just scare your opponent.
Yeah,
you
lose like, he's a game, here for business.
You lose a game as top player, you say, you know what? What's your bans, man? Like, you act like you don't care at all, and you scare them. That's the trick.
Yeah. All right, man, so moving on to our next game.
Yep. I didn't see what stage they're picking.
Yeah, I think I missed. Oh, Lilac. Oh, okay. So this is HBox's counterpick. He's opting for the Lilac. I mean, I can see that.
Yep, the three platforms means that even one platform is covered by Tidro, the other two are safe. It's a long stage with lots of landing opportunities for HBox to abuse. And this stage was amazing for Pikachu in Smash 4 because he could quick attack cancel, but now he can no longer do that.
Yeah, all that's gone, man. They took it away from Greninja too in the last patch. I was so sad.
Good.
He used to be able to actually do that off slants. He'd be able to jump out of it or honestly just immediately act out, and they took that away, so.
Yep.
Oh, well.
One thing to watch out for is if Cam wants to play like that, he can actually camp behind the platforms, like underneath and behind them, and stop HBox's full-up approaches and force more predictable short-hop approaches.
You can see him actually doing that too, man. He's opting to sit back and just throw more jolts. I mean, he's allowed to do that. He's allowed to play that game, sitting at a great angle to stop HBox from approaching him as well. And it's not like HBox is playing a character that's fast enough to one run under the full hop jolts and actually get a punish unless he's super close.
Yep. And you see, Campbell recognizes HBox wants to use those platforms. He's kind of like, he's up to try to call out HBox's runoff platforms and jump over platforms. It's just a matter of how effectively he can do that.
But yeah.
Uh-oh, getting out range from the forward, a down throw, up air, can't do anything else. Yeah, as mentioned before, look, that drift during air dodge is so good that HBox can escape despite how laggy air dodge is.
Yeah. Alright, so kicking through these jolts too, man. I mean, that was something I got punished a little earlier on, but it's still obviously effective for him to do, especially if he catches Campbell running in after a jolt. But Campbell, I think he's opt to stop running in after jolts as much, and now he's kind of like, you know, he's down to throw like two or three different jolts before he decides, you know what, maybe I'll go in now.
Yep.
Here we go.
Uh-oh.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Oh, my God. He definitely had the read, though.
That happens all the time.
I'm not sure if HBox... too early? Yeah.
I'm assuming HBox has smash stick. And there's something interesting that happens in this game is if you're holding a direction, like, say, holding left on the analog stick, holding right for a C-stick, a lot of times you'll get, like, a smash input or a forward turn input in the direction the analog stick is facing and not the C-stick.
Okay.
Like, right there.
Honestly, maybe that's what's going on. Maybe he's doing a lot of reverse F-smash. I might have to just ask him later because... You know, I like the first few looked like the read, but that definitely like an accident. There's no reason to throw that one back there.
Oh yeah, definitely not. Right now, HBox has a pretty commendable lead. He just needs one back here to close it out.
There it is.
Commentator's curse.
There it is. Yep. Commentator's blessing right there. Just needs one, and you gave it to him. He's like, you mean this right here?
Yeah. Like I said, I'm coaching these players through commentary.
Yeah. All right. So now HBox taking the lead here. Good for him. I mean, again, with the way that he was playing in that last game, even if I did win the last game, I'd still be thinking about that. You know, the fact that, like, I had a solid lead. The man gave up a stock at, like, 3%, and it still brought it to the point where it was last stock, last hit in the second game.
Yep, and now it's... I was about to say, that's commentator's curse. I was about to say, so it's kill HBox, and then he dies.
That reverse up smash.
Yeah, that's one thing that I feel like Campbell can actually fish for a bit more, because Jigglypuff doesn't have a hard punish on, like, those up smashes. Like... She's too floaty to do, like, fast fall rest or, like, fast fall smash.
Yeah, so the best thing you can probably get is maybe, you know, just to pressure the shield, possibly, like, a fast fall down air, or not down air, but neutral air or something like that. And, like, yeah, that's going to be some damage, but you didn't die. So, like, yeah, there's no reason for him not to be able to try to go for more up smashes. But, oh, my God. Oh, he still did it!
Oh, what? Okay. What? Oh, he's being extra right now. He doesn't need to charge that smash.
Wait until he woke up.
Uh-oh, they actually had to catch the ledge jump. Yeah, a ledge jump in this game is interesting because you're vulnerable lower to your ledge jump than in Smash 4.
Uh-huh.
So it's like in Smash 4, every character does like a handstand for the most part and then jumps, and then they're vulnerable once in the air. In this game, during the handstand itself, a lot of characters are vulnerable.
Yeah, no, it's super quick, so it's a little more risky in this game. Still, obviously, you should throw out every now and then. You mix up your recovery from the ledge, but yeah, I've seen a lot of people getting blown up with a marked F smash as they're trying to jump off the ledge, so.
You see, HBox just needs a back air. Commentator's blessing? Nope.
almost got the commentator blessing with the neutral air. He at least pushed him off stage, though. He's lining it up.
What? Uh-oh.
The bait?
Yeah, the baits. Oh, she's fishing my backer. Yep. And right now, I'm not sure what Campbell's really fishing for. Like, he needs to obviously not die, so he can't force trades, but he can't really kill HBox, yes.
Yeah.
Unless he wants to go for, like, a hard read smash and... I don't know.
Ooh, okay, getting out of that situation. Neutral air yet again. I mean, that's a lot of aerials until, like, immediate roll-in. If he's too close to HBox, I feel like if he catches on that, he might be able to get, like, a clean dash check, possibly even an F smash kill if he gets the roll behind, so.
Yep, trying to pressure these down tilts. Uh-oh, that's such a scary dash check to do.
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
Bless. Another back air for granted by DeBuzz to yep. HBox to see what he can do on this third stock, though, man. I would definitely like to see HBox end this in some clean fashion.
Yep, no, Campbell wants that kill right now. He's got
fishing. Oh! Great spacing on that.
He goes fishing, he gets a nice catch.
Yeah.
Honestly, HBox needs to stop corning himself so much when he has a lead. I feel like that's a big part of it, is he's not camping the platforms and letting Campbell come to him. Like, he's putting himself in the corner and giving Campbell these chances.
Yeah, if he played with that, like, same level of patience that he has when he has a lead in Melee, I think this match would be a totally different way. Because, yeah, as you were noticing, pointing out, I feel like he gets a little more aggressive when he has the lead. It's weird to me that I feel like he should just want to, like, play the game that we've known him for a long time.
I also don't like the ILF for HBox because, honestly, a lot of his approaches are very predictable due to the platform stopping his movement.
Yeah.
And this honestly feels like it was a better stage for Campbell than HBox.
Yeah, well, Campbell's starting to, he's got the lead right now.
Yeah.
And now he's playing the more of a patient game, so.
Yep.
And I'm noticing that HBox is kind of consciously not drifting into a shield nearly as much, though, so that's good for him.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh, this is bad. I feel like it's such a long match too. Like I feel like HBox should have the advantage in terms of just long term like stamina. But
yeah,
it feels like Camel is abusing that too.
Yeah, I mean, maybe this is how Camel plays all the time too. Maybe he's always been like that. Oh yeah, I'm the more patient. I'm the most patient Pikachu.
Yeah.
Because that's what it looks like. And this might not even be a good matchup thing. This might just be his play style.
Nope. Yeah, okay. I thought he was gonna side B like last time, but yeah, now he learned. He definitely was like remembering that first time.
Oh, there we go. Yep, that's it. Done. Goodbye. Oh,
and you know
there
what happened,
we go.
Actually, Camel dash attacked and he spot dodged after dash attack because that wasn't a guaranteed rest out of shield. No way.
I think he probably should have made him like roll away or something like that.
He should have actually held shield. If anything, let HBox.
Well, yeah, if he would have held shield, yeah, because you can't get rested through shield, so he could have just got a free up smash after it was over, or
yeah,
just
exactly.
Anything. To be honest.
Anything.